Hello friends, this is Yogesh Muromkar. In this video, we are going to talk about subqueries, or it is also called as nested subqueries. So we are going to talk about this particular statement: implement nested subqueries, perform a test for set membership, that is in, not in, then set comparison, and set cardinality, that is unique, not unique, etc. So we are going to calculate first highest salary, second highest salary, how we can use subqueries for that. We are going to talk about that here. So this is the table we are going to use, that is EMP. We have 13 rows in this particular table, and one more table we are going to use is DEPD table, that is department. So EMP is having these columns, and DEPD is having department number, department name, and location column. So based on this, we are going to see some questions, and then we are going to write down subqueries for those questions, or SQL queries for those questions. So display employee name and salary for those who earn more than blank. This is the first query. So we want to find out name of those employees and the salary of those employees who earn more than blank. So when we use subquery, whenever there is a missing information. So we don't know what is the salary of blank. That's why we are going to use subquery for this. So the query is going to be like this: select ename comma sal from EMP, where sal greater than, and in brackets, in parentheses, we are going to write down a query to find out what is blank's salary. So select sal from EMP, where ename is equal to blank. So this query is going to give us salary of blank. So it is called as subquery. So see, these are the people who are having, these are the employees who are having salary greater than blank. If you look at blank's salary, you can check, and then you can check the salaries of these people: Jones, Scott, King, and Ford. It is greater than blank salary. Next question: display employee name and department number for those who work at Dallas. Now this query can be written based on two tables, because in EMP table we do not have a column called as location. That column is present in DEPD table, but we need to display employee name, department number for those employees who work at Dallas. So what we are going to do is, we are going to write down a query which is based on two tables, employee and department. So select ename comma department number from EMP, where department number is equal to, select department number from DEPD table, where LOC, that is location, is equal to Dallas City. So this is a subquery using which you can find out employee name and department number for the people who are working at Dallas. So you can look at the data which is present in employee table and DEPD table, and then you can easily understand how to find out this particular answer with the help of subquery. So this is the answer: these are the employee names who are working at Dallas. Next query: display employee number and department number for those who either work in Blake's or Miller's department. So we want to find out the people who are also working in the same department in which Miller or Blake works. So here there is again a missing information. What is the missing information? We don't know in which department either Blake works or Miller works. We don't know the departments of these two employees. That's why we should use subquery. We should go for subquery to solve this kind of question. So select ename comma department number from EMP, where department number in, here we should have department numbers of Blake and Miller. Blake and Miller. So how you can find out the department numbers of Blake and Miller? Using this query, using the subquery which we are writing inside the parenthesis, that is select department number from EMP, where ename equal to Blake or ename equal to Miller. This subquery is going to give us department number of those two people, and then we are going to find out the employee name and department number of the other employees who are also working in the same department in which either Miller works or Blake works. So you can find out 10 and 30. Okay. So that was the answer. Next query: display employee name and salary for highest salary earner. Now we need to write down the query to display name of the employee who earns the highest salary. Name of the employee and salary of that employee who is earning highest salary. So you can write down a subquery for this in this way: select ename comma sal from EMP. Now we want to display the name also. That's why I'm writing ename comma sal. But that sal we want as a maximum sal, that is maximum salary. So how you can find out? Select ename comma sal from EMP, where sal is equal to maximum salary. But we don't know what is maximum salary, though here there are 14 records only, but if there are more number of records, you can find out maximum salary the person, the name and maximum salary of that person by using that particular subquery. So we have written select ename comma salary from EMP where salary equal to select max of salary from EMP. That was the answer. Next question, display employee name and salary for second highest salary earner. Earlier we found out the name and the salary of the employee who was earning highest salary. Now the next question, we want to find out name and salary of the person whose salary is second highest. So again this can be solved by using subquery because there is a missing information. So this is the query, select ename comma salary from EMP where, now we need to write down two queries inside a query. So where sal equal to select max is a function, it's aggregate function, we know we have used it in earlier query also. Sal equal to select max of sal from EMP where we need to write down one more query because we want second highest. So where sal less than select max function, again we are going to use, so select max of sal, that is max of salary from EMP. So the first query is going to give us all the salaries except the highest salary, and from those remaining salaries we are going to find out the maximum. So these two people are there who are having second highest salary out of those 13 people in employee table. Now third question is display employee name and salary for the third highest salary earner. So this question again can be solved by using subquery. So in earlier question there were two queries we had written inside a query. Now here we need to write down three queries because the question is we need to find out name and salary of the employee who is earning third highest salary. So there will be three inner queries for this particular subquery. So again select ename comma sal from EMP where sal equal to, so here we are going to write down three queries again. Earlier we written two, in this case there will be three total. So where sal equal to select max of sal from EMP, we need to write down one more query because in this case we want third highest salary. Okay, so where sal, we want sal less than second highest. Okay, so where sal less than, we need to write down one more query here. So select max of sal from EMP and then again where clause. So select max of sal from EMP, as we want third highest salary, that's why we are going to write down where clause here and one more query where sal, that is salary less than select max of sal from EMP, that is EMP table. So you can compare earlier query and this query. Earlier there were only two inner queries, here one more extra. So this is the person who is earning third highest salary, the name is Jones. So in this way you can find out first highest salary, second highest salary and third highest salary. But what you can notice here is writing down these kind of subqueries is going to be very very difficult. Okay, so what you can do is we can have another way also. So we are going to take check in next question, the third highest salary earner without using subquery. So how to find out third highest salary earner without using subquery, that's what we are going to discuss in this question. So we are going to solve the previous question once again but without using subquery. So how to do that, let us check. So select ename comma distinct sal from EMP table, order by, as we already know what is the order by clause, to put it in ascending or descending order, order by sal descending, DESC means descending, limit offset, we want which, we want third highest salary, right? For third highest salary we want, so what we can do is we can limit it to 2. This particular query is going to give us the third highest salary. So okay, what is the mistake, I think select ename, okay, ename comma sal offset 2 offset 3, okay, it is also not working. I think what I have done here is it is select ename comma distinct sal, okay, this distinct keyword should be after select, that was a mistake. So it is select distinct sal comma ename from emp. Again, it is showing undeclared variable offset. Okay, it is why it is showing the error. I need to check it actually. Why it is showing the error? Select distinct sal comma ename, it is right, from emp, order by sal descending. I think I am making a mistake in syntax. Okay, yes, it is. It should be limit one. I want to display only one salary. Then again, also it is showing error. Order by sal descending. Okay, that was a mistake. Limit space one. It should be limit space one. So see, it is showing you second highest salary actually. If you put offset two, that means it is showing you second highest salary. Offset 2 it will show you the second highest salary, and if you put offset 3 it will show you fourth highest salary. So this question: for the highest salary earner in each department, okay, display employee name, salary and department number for the highest salary earner in each department. So earlier we have seen how to find out nth highest salary. We are going to see more examples also, but let us first of all solve this question: to display employee name, salary and department number for the highest salary earner in each department. That is how to use group by clause to solve this kind of query. We can see from this particular query how to find out nth highest salary. Those examples we are again going to revisit. The answer for this query is select ename comma sal comma department number from emp, where sal in select max of sal from emp group by department number. So we already seen group by clause. So this query is going to give highest salary earner department wise. Okay, now find out eighth highest salary earner. So we are again going revisiting this particular question. I want what? Eighth highest salary earner. So I should put 7 here, offset 7. So this is the eighth highest salary earner. The name is Turner. You can go and check into EMP table also. Okay, so Turner is a person who is earning eighth highest salary among all people. So it is very easy to find out nth highest salary. Next, if I want to know the person with person who is earning fourth highest salary, so this is the person Jones, right? So you can check it, Jones. So in our case, as there are two people who are having same salaries, so that's why you might be saying that the Jones is third person, but according to offset you put a number and you will get the salary. So if you check, actually Jones is the third highest salary earner, but he is the fourth person. That's what I am saying. So this is the way how you can find out nth highest salary according without doing sub query. If I want to find out ninth highest salary earner, this is the query. So Martin is the person, right? So this is all about sub queries and nth highest salary you can find out. So I am going to provide this document in the description below the video. So that's it. Thank you very much.